Alcoholics Anonymous is an offshoot of the Oxford Group movement, which aspired to live by the teachings of Jesus Christ. In its infancy, AA split off and distinguished itself as a fellowship whose primary purpose is to stay sober and help other alcoholics achieve sobriety. The only requirement for membership is a desire to stop drinking, and all are welcome, regardless of faith or creed. Though Christian in origin, the 12 steps were altered so as to make them acceptable to persons of any faith or no faith. Nowhere does the literature proclaim Jesus Christ as Lord Savior, and AA members are encouraged to find a higher power of their own understanding.
A lot of people come in and hear the word God and want to grab religion.
I mean, in some ways it does appear like a religion, depending on what your definition is. I mean, the court system has said it's a religion.
The defense is that AA is not a religious program. It has aspects of spirituality, but it's not a religion per se.
My sponsor told me right up front, he said, you know, your higher power is yours to define.
And what she said to me was, you need to find a God that you'd be willing to have coffee with.
It doesn't have to be a body hung on a cross. You don't have to be a sitting Buddha. It takes out all the particulars.
God is inside of you and inside of me. He's sitting right next to me.
I understand God as love, life, truth.
God is not gendered. My God is bigger than that. And language defines reality.
You know, people use omnipotence and awesome, and you know, and those are all limited words to me.
In Native American way, we call it the great mystery. I'm not here to solve it. I'm not here to understand it. I'm here to just accept it.
People that have a difficult time with the concept of God or concept of religion will use the love that they feel in the 12-step meeting rooms.
I heard a lady say one time, God won't do for me what I can do for myself. And there's too much turning it over to God. No, there should be a lot more getting off your dead butt and doing something about it.
When you begin to say God to people, spirituality to people, the Bible to people, they immediately conjure up all kinds of bad religious experience. And those are just that. They're bad religious experiences. They're not experiences with God.
You know, they always say, yeah, we're made in the image of God. And so here I'm this little black kid. And it's kind of like the psychology of a black kid. They grow up, and when they're a little kid, they go to different churches. They go to a black church, and they look up, and there's a white man with long blonde hair, and he's God or he's Jesus. And he looks like Charleston Heston. And I'm like, I don't look like that. Something's not right, you know?
God, as we understand him, you know, you have to ask yourself, do you understand yourself first?
The idea, though, is a recognition we are not God. We are not infinite. You know, on the one hand, we are capable of this altruism, this beauty of human nature that is divine. And on the other hand, we are periodically reminded of our ties to the stinking earth. We are going someday to die and rot.
Yo pienso que los árabes en millones van a la Meca a cumplir su cita con Alá. Y los católicos van también, el deseo es ir a Roma, al Vaticano. Y yo pienso que todos los alcohólicos del mundo es nuestro deseo venir algún día a Akron. Yo pienso que es nuestro Vaticano, es nuestra Meca.
In 1935, in Akron, Ohio, one drunk helped another get sober, marking the beginning of AA. 73 years later, this fellowship has grown to a membership of nearly 2 million worldwide. What's come to be known as the Big Book of AA has been translated into over 50 languages. In addition, an estimated 550 other fellowships have patterned themselves after the same 12-step model to overcome every kind of addiction imaginable.
The 12 steps are fundamental truths. Fundamental truths are grounded in every religious tradition and no religious tradition.
Yeah, after I looked at these 12 steps and I read them, and I began to realize, I thought, you know, they could have been crafted by a Hindu.
All those points, 12 points, referred to in this book, Alcohol Anonymous, definitely be applicable to the Islamic faith.
The 12 steps to me are God-inspired. It's God's gift to the world, I like to think. It's the greatest contribution, spiritual contribution, to the Western world in the last 500 years.
This guy said, "You know, I didn't come into AA to save my soul. I came in to save my ass. And I was around for 2 years before I realized they were connected." That's why hanging around with AA is to hear lines like that.